Chapter 1. He adored Guildford. He idolized it all out of proportion. He romanticized it all out of proportion. Yeah. To him, no matter what the season was, this was still a town that existed in black and white and pulsated to the great tunes of George Gershwin. Wait, let me start this over. Chapter 1. He was too romantic about Guildford, as he was about everything else. He thrived on the hustle-bustle of the crowds and the traffic. To him, Guildford meant beautiful women and street-smart guys who seemed to know all the angles. Nah, corny. Too corny for a man of my taste. Let me try and make this more profound. Chapter 1. He adored Guildford. To him, it was a metaphor for the decay of contemporary culture. The same lack of individual integrity that caused so many people to take the easy way out was rapidly turning the town of his dreams in... Nah, it's gonna be too preachy. I mean, let's face it, you know, I want to sell some books here. Chapter 1. He adored Guildford, although to him, it was a metaphor for the decay of contemporary culture. How hard it was to exist in a society desensitized by drugs, loud music, television, crime, garbage. Too angry. I don't want to be angry. Chapter 1. He was as tough and romantic as the city he loved. Behind his black-rimmed glasses was the coiled sexual power of a jungle cat. I love this. Guildford was his town, and it always would be.